reserve Navy. And before we left Quonset, before they closed Quonset down, we were training with nuke torpedoes. And when they closed Quonset, we moved to South Weymouth. I drove the truck with the four nukes in it that we owned. Well, here's the thing. When we first started moving, somebody tried to run one of the trucks off the road to get in, you know, to steal everything out of the truck. So they had us running in caravans. There was like three of us driving trucks. We said there all three of us would go together. And then, we make a couple of runs of all three of us. Then we come back to Quonset. And I pull up to the hangar. CEO comes out and he goes, "Let me have the keys to your truck." I said, "Why? Did I do something wrong?" He goes, "No, I just need the keys to your truck." So I hand him the keys. He hands them to this Marine. The Marine jumps in my truck and drives off with it. And I went, "How am I gonna drive my load back if he's just taking off in my truck?" He goes, "Don't worry about it." He says, "You'll get your truck back. Don't worry about it." So, the other two guys, the trucks are fully loaded, and the CO tells them, he goes, "Take off." He goes, "We gotta wait for Mullen." He goes, "No, you two take off. Don't worry about Mullen." So I look at the guys and go, "I guess I'll be seeing you on the next trip." So all of a sudden, my truck comes back. I walk around the back of the truck, there's a Pentagon lock on it. And I'm like,
"They want wrecked. They're trying to get wrecked real quick."
It's like, what the fuck? You know? And so the CEO goes, "Okay, you can go up to Weymouth." And I went, "Wait a minute, you want me to drive all alone to Weymouth?" And he goes, "Yeah, you're on your own." And I went, "You know what happened to the last truck that went solo?" And he goes, "Yeah, just don't stop." I'm going up 95, just this side of Providence. I look in front of me, I'm going, "That's a fucking government car." So I look in front of me and I'm sitting there going, "That's a government car." There's five guys in the government car. And they're all pretty beefy looking guys. So I'm sitting there looking. No. So I'm looking at these guys in the car in front of me. All of a sudden I look down in the lane next to me. There's another government car full of guys. And I look in the mirror. I got two more behind me. And I'm sitting there going, "You fucking assholes.
Just in case you want to go stop yourself."
Yeah. Fucking assholes. Because I put two and two together. I said, "I'm not alone out here." And I said, "If I got this much firepower around me, I know what's in the back of this fucking truck. You know, a Pentagon lock, you know, all the secrecy." So I get up to Weymouth. I get up to my hangar. There's a whole fucking Marine attachment sitting there with the guns and everything. Pull up and the guy yells at me, "Leave keys in the truck, get out of the truck, get out of the way." The guy jumps in the truck and the whole attachment takes off in my truck. And the guy's looking at me, I'm going, "Oh, they gotta go put the nukes away." And the maintenance officer's standing there going, "What?" I went, "Nothing."
Yeah, you're not supposed to know what you're doing.
And he goes, "What'd you just say?" And I sit there with, "Don't fucking bullshit me, I know what's in the truck." So when they were closing Weymouth, I'm sitting there going, "So they take the four nukes out that I drove up here?" And they go, "There's no nukes in Weymouth." And I went, "Yeah, there is, because I fucking drove them up here from Quonset." "No, they told us there's no..." never been any nukes in Weymouth. Okay? And you believe the government. Yeah, you can believe whatever you want. I know what I drove up here. Then when I was down in Quonset, I always had the midnight to four hangar watch. And I got bored one night, so I took all the top secret messages. Took like four or five of them, laid them out on the counter. And sat there studying, you know, pattern recognition. It took me about a half an hour to break the code so I could read them. But I didn't bother telling anybody. Until the day we got the message in saying they were going to put us on the, that they were looking at putting my squadron on the USS Wasp and sending us to the Gulf of Tonkin Yacht Club. So when the maintenance officer came in that morning, I said, sir, you need to read this because they want to send us to Nam. And he grabbed a message and he goes off in his office. He's in there reading it and he's all in a panic, you know, because he didn't want to go. He's in a panic. He didn't want to go. And, three quarters of the way through the day, all of a sudden I get a phone call. Get your ass in my office. Yeah. So I go in his office. I says, is there a problem, sir? And he goes, yeah, there's a big problem. I said, what's that? He goes, one, this is a top secret message. Yes, sir. And he goes, two, you don't have a clearance to read top secret messages. True. He goes, how the hell did you know what this said? Well, I kind of guessed at it. Like, yeah. He goes, guess my ass. He says, you know what this means? I says, no, I don't. He sits there and he goes, you're going to get a visit. He says, a visit? He goes, yeah. The NIS shows up. Who taught you how to read these? Nobody. Well, how do you know what it says? Sit there and they go, well, the code's been changed. I says, yeah, I promised my officer I wouldn't play around with it. So, says, I promised my officer I wouldn't play around with it. So we sit there and he goes,